I was addicted to my phone. As soon as I would wake up in the morning, I'd be on my phone. If I was waiting for a friend, I'd be on my phone. Even when I was talking to a friend, I'd be on my phone. Even when I was trying to work, pretending to work, I would be on my phone. And the very last thing I did before I went to sleep was go on my phone. But can you blame me? 3.5 billion people across the planet own a smartphone. And just like I used to, people struggle to put it down. The average American spends 5 hours a day on their smartphone. The problem is that literally billions of dollars are being spent by massive corporations to get our attention onto our phones and to not let it go. So how can we fight back? How can we regain our freedom? Well, in this very video, I'm going to reveal three of the little hacks that they're using to just get you addicted to your smartphone. And then towards the end of the video, together, we're going to work through the process on this very video, not just theory, but actually taking action to remove this addiction from your phone so you can stop spending time staring at a pixel and start spending time truly living. I'm sure we all know when it comes to building a habit, we need a cue, a routine, and a reward. And funnily enough, smartphone manufacturers know this very well, and they fit into this habit loop perfectly. It starts with a cue. Smartphone manufacturers aren't just happy enough to have your attention when you decide to go on your phone. They want to have your attention when they want to have your attention. They want to be in control of where your attention goes instead of letting you decide where that goes. And the way they do that is through notifications. They're the ones in control of when notifications are sent. So they get to decide when you pick up your phone and when you don't. How many of you, when you heard that sound that was just played, had the urge to check your smartphone? And this shows how powerful the cue is for getting you to pick up your phone and to start going on it. And then we've got the routine. Just imagine that you're trying to start the good habit of going to the gym regularly. So you have the cue set down, you've added it into your calendar, you see on your calendar that you're going to go to the gym, and then you've got to walk 20 minutes to go to the gym, let alone get changed, put on the stuff, go to the gym and actually work out. There's a lot of friction there, and the harder the routine is to do, the less likely you are to do it. On this channel, we've talked about before how humans, just like electricity and just like water, we follow the path of least resistance. If something's easy, we're far more likely to do it. So why do you think that smartphone manufacturers have put such an emphasis and spent so much money and so much time on making something that's small enough to put into your pocket? It means that you're carrying around this device wherever you go. The routine is frictionless. Literally all you have to do, reach into your pocket and take it out. And finally, you have the reward. Now, this is what your brain does to reinforce behaviors. It provides you with chemicals that make you feel good. But again, the smartphone manufacturers have tapped into this. And I'm not going to go too deep into this. We've covered this in great depth in my free course here on YouTube, the Mental Momentum Dopamine Detox course. So if you haven't already checked it out, click the link in the description. It's going to walk you through all of this in far more depth. And the way you get the reward is mostly down to the apps that you're using on your phone. If you're on Facebook or Instagram or Reddit, you go to the top of the page, you swipe down a little bit, it's going to refresh your page. And they've carefully engineered this to make it very slim to a slot machine. It makes you feel like you're in control, when in reality all you're getting is a fresh feed of novel ideas. As well as this, if you post a picture on Instagram, it's rumored that they don't show you how many likes you're getting for a delayed period of time. This means your body is refreshing and refreshing, looking at your notifications, wondering why you're not getting as many likes as you normally do. They do this because there's such a thing as a variable rate reward. If you don't know what the outcome's going to be, you're far more likely to stick around, and it's going to release more chemicals in your brain. Again, we've discussed this. I'm not going to go into it at length. So now we have an obvious cue, a frictionless routine, and a satisfying reward. No wonder so many of us spend so much time on our phone. It's literally been engineered so that it's almost impossible to not spend time on our phone. So how do we fight against this? How can we claim back where our attention goes so that we are in control of our life, not those people in Silicon Valley? Well, let's go through this and make sure you've got your phone on you, because this channel, we're time theorists. We're people who take action. We don't just consume. So make sure you've got your phone on you. We're going to walk through the theory, and I'm going to provide you action items every step of the way. So let's start with the cue. The better that you can control your environment, the better that you can dictate hate the behavior that you do. You want to make good behaviors the path of least resistance and bad behaviors almost impossible. And the best way to do this is to really drill deep and figure out the best way to avoid negative cues when it comes to using your smartphone. First of all, you've got to take control of your phone's homepage. How many times have you gone on your phone to do one thing, and because there's another app on your homepage, you've ended up doing something else? One idea that you could do is put literally every single app on your phone into a folder. This way, the only easy way that you can find the apps you want to use is by pulling down and searching the specific name of the app. This way, when you're going on your phone, you're deciding what you should be doing. You're searching in the name of the app instead of going on and getting distracted. Another thing you can do is get rid of notifications, especially notifications for things that you genuinely don't want to be doing. If there's a notification from a game like Clash of Clans, get rid of it. This purely serves as a distraction. And another thing, you can just put your phone on silent mode or do not disturb mode. So the first action item is to go through and reduce the cues when it comes to your smartphone. Let's move on to routine. I've got three different suggestions for you. First of all, you want to add as much friction to doing a bad behavior as possible. So go through and delete the apps that you don't want to be doing. This way, if you want to use it, you've got to go to the App Store or the Play Store and re-download it again. If you want to add another layer of friction, forget the password on your Play Store or your App Store, so every single time you've got to manually enter it in, or even generate a long string of random characters, which you can do from a random password generator, just Google it. And that way, if you ever want to download an app again, you're going to have to go and find a piece of paper that you've hidden in your room. The principle is simple, just add friction to what you're doing. Or you can literally move your phone further away from you. When I was going to school and university, what I would do is I would put my phone in my bag. Instead of having it in my pocket where it was easy to reach and I could do it unconsciously, I would put it into my bag. That way there's at least a few seconds of time that I've really got to think, right, let me pull out my phone. There's no chance I'm going to pull it out when I'm in a conversation with someone. There's no chance I'm going to pull it out when I shouldn't. There's this added friction to doing that behavior. Or you can download the Forest app, which you can use when you're studying. You can set the exact amount of time that you want to be studying. And if you don't go on your phone, you plant a tree. Literally in real life, trees are planted from this app. Whereas if you do go on your phone, that tree gets destroyed and you're actually not planting trees in real life. It's a cool app. So the action item here is to add friction to the routine. And then we move on to reward. Let's do an experiment. Which of these colors do your eyes naturally go to? Where are your eyes naturally drawn? It's probably the red, right? As humans, we're naturally drawn to warm colors like bright red and bright orange. Look at the logos for these companies and you'll notice that they're often bright red. It's because our eyes get attracted to that because it's a sign of danger, it's a sign of warning. So there's a reason why your notifications are all red. They do this because it's almost impossible for you not to click on those notifications and to go into that app because it's red. It's like your brain is saying urgent, 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 you need to click on this. But that is not the case whatsoever. So when it comes to reducing rewards for negative things, there's a couple options on your phone. Either you can put your phone onto grayscale, where there's not going to be reds, everything's going to be gray, and it's going to be less stimulating for your eyes and less likely you're going to be clicking on these things. Or you can delete the apps that give you the most stimulating results. Whether that's TikTok or Instagram or Reddit, delete those negative apps that give you large rewards and you're far less likely to go on your phone. That's another action item. And if you go through and you do these three action items, what you're going to find is you're far more likely to actually start living in the real life. You're going to be more present. You'll live your life more intentionally. You're the one in control, not those men in Silicon Valley. If you've enjoyed this video, click the like button and subscribe, and that way more videos like this one are going to show up on your homepage. Also on the screen right now is a video that's going to explain to you why your environment is so important, so go and check out that video.